Hey y'all! Today we're going to be discussing muscle contraction and relaxation in very easy steps.
So what components I need to initiate a muscle contraction? So number one, neuromuscular junctions, in which they will have a motor neuron. Specifically, we need the synaptic button. Second, we need a neurotransmitter, specifically the one called acetylcholine, for short ACH, and of course ACH receptors in the muscle end plate. Within the muscle, we're also going to be needing the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which is also known as the endoplasmic reticulum. Within the sarcoplasmic reticulum, there is a triad, which consists of two terminal cistern and a transverse T-tubule. And we're also going to be needing calcium, which is inside the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Last but not least, we're also going to be needing actin thin filaments, myosin thick filaments, and also two additional proteins that are within actin thin filaments. That is tropomyosin and troponin. So we're going to start here at the neuromuscular junction, which is basically a connection between a motor neuron and a muscle. So if you listen to the word itself, neuromuscular junction, neuro as in the neuron, muscular as in the muscle, junction as it is this area right here in between that motor neuron and the muscle. Particularly, we're going to look into the synaptic button, right? So if we zoom in here, right, this is what you're going to be seeing. You're going to be seeing that axon terminal, particularly that synaptic button, that is filled with acetylcholine, or ACH for short. And if you notice, there's going to be a space in between these two structures, in between the axon terminal and the muscle itself, the muscle end plate. We call that the synaptic cleft. On the other end, you're going to have these receptors called the ACH receptors that basically open to let sodium in. So sodium is going to enter. Once sodium enters, there's going to be a depolarization of the membrane. This depolarization is going to travel through the T-tubules towards the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, once that action potential reaches the T-tubules, like I said, this is going to activate the sarcoplasmic reticulum to release the calcium from this triad. So calcium is going to be released. It's going to go towards the actin thin filaments. Particularly, it's going to go towards troponin and tropomyosin, because troponin and tropomyosin are enclosing the myosin binding sites. And if the myosin binding sites are closed, that means that myosin cannot create a cross bridge with the actin thin filaments. But thanks to calcium, calcium allows the movement or shift of troponin and tropomyosin, allowing the exposure of myosin binding sites. Right? And once the active site exposure, we're going to have a cross bridge formation between myosin and actin thin filaments, creating eventually a contraction in the sarcomere.
Discussion break. First, what is a neuromuscular junction? Second, what is the sarcoplasmic reticulum? And three, what is the particular neurotransmitter that is used for muscle contraction?
Now let's dive into the steps to end a muscle contraction. But first, what components do I need to end muscle contraction? So the first one is going to be ACHE. We're going to need acetylcholine esterase, which breaks down ACH. And two, we're going to need a calcium reuptake by the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So to finish or end the muscle contraction, we're going to start here at the synaptic cleft. And for this, we're going to need ACH to be removed by ACHE. Once that happens, they detach from the receptors, closing those receptors, and sodium cannot enter anymore. This will stop the action potentials. And then the sarcoplasmic reticulum is going to recapture that calcium back. Then the active sites cover, again by troponin and tropomyosin. And there's not going to be more cross-bridge interaction between actin and myosynthetic filaments. This is going to stop that contraction, creating a relaxation in the muscle. And that's it.
Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Gonzalez. I'll see you the next time.